guys, back to the Transformers review, finally. It's been, what, 2 months, I think? And today I'm doing the Dark of the Moon Shockwave figure. The Voyager class, purple guy. I'm not gonna do a whole lot of Dark of the Moon reviews because I don't like the toy line. I really don't. In fact, there's three that come to mind I actually like, and that's Shockwave, Sentinel, which is kind of a letdown, and then Leader Ironhide. Besides them, I don't plan to get anything else. So, enjoy this while you can. I really like this figure, though. When we first saw the Shockwave figure, I knew I had to get him. I am a little bummed that he's a Voyager. If you've seen any of my reviews, especially, I think, the movie ones, one of my major complaints is, I wish we had a bigger version of the toy. And I would love to see this guy as a leader figure. There are a couple of sculpting issues that I do have with the Voyager class figure, but overall, he is fantastic. And I want a bigger version of him. If anything, because his light piping for his one little eye is so cool, I would love to have just a button, you know, maybe on his chest, slide the little rib cage down and have that light up by itself. That would look very, very, very cool. He has the nice G1 purple going. It's a bit duller than his G1 toy, and I really should have grabbed it and brought it down for comparison, but really, eh. But it fits the figure quite nicely, and I feel a sneeze coming on, so you may hear a sudden, wait. Oh, it's gone. Okay, anyway. Still there. Ooh, tickle. It is a kind of a dull purple. It doesn't stand up. It's not like a really flashy kind of look. It works for the toy very nicely. It fits him. He has this really nice kind of a lighter shade purple all through here. And just really looks fantastic. A lot of these figures don't have a lot of paint apps. They seem just slapped together with the plastic and then that's it. But this guy has a lot of nice paint detailings and it really does shine through. Articulation wise for this robot mode, because that's how he comes packaged. The arms have full rotation at the shoulders. Woohoo! They can swing out to the sides along here. You can rotate here. The elbow can bend. Now the elbow I'm kind of iffy on. You can't rotate his wrist. His wrists are stuck with this just forward and back, and that's just for the transformation, really. So if you want to have actual elbow movement, you have to rotate the arm like that and then have it kind of in this come here kind of thing. I don't care for that too much. It also bugs me that they have this reversed, it looks like, with the screws facing inwards. I'm really tempted to take this apart and then swap the hands out and then see if I could get it where it's looking kind of like that for each side. That would look a whole lot better, and I'm not sure why they went with having the screws facing inward like that. That does kind of bug me thumb. But oh well. Waist movements, there's none. I mean, yeah, there's none. Nothing at all. The legs can go forward. They can go back really far forward. He can almost kick himself in the head. That's a really good kick. And they can swing out to the sides, but they are very, very strong ratcheted joints. And you can get his legs closer inwards. That's a little too close. But the way his feet are sculpted, you're meant to have him in this kind of legs kind of spread kind of standing pose. They're actually sculpted at this weird little angle, so he's meant to stand like that. Kind of bugs me a little bit, but when you look at the overall toy, it's like he would stand like that. You go to his knees, they can bend like that. They can bend a little bit toward the front, a little bit, but not so much. And his heel can move from the transformation. His ankle, or his toesies, if you unclip them, you can kind of move them, and that probably could add some kind of new posing abilities, but they're meant to be locked in place like that. And last but not least, his little head, it can rotate. Yay! That's fantastic. It's gonna have a rotating head. Now, while I do have him in this mode, he does come with the mech tech weapons. Now, the mech tech is a feature that I think is really dumb for the most part. It's a nice idea. It's taking the whole automorph kind of thing and making it into a weapon. That's fine and dandy, hunky-dory, all that kind of stuff. But most of the time, they don't look right. It's nice that they're actually incorporating it in the movie itself. We've seen images of you know, the cars with the guns coming out, that kind of stuff. But most of them just look dumb. Shockwaves, however, works very nicely for me. Clips onto his arm here. His hand can fold away, and I'll show it without the gun attached. And you push the little lever back here, and you get his little springy gun action going. And I'll actually pull that up so it doesn't get caught. If you push hard enough, you can actually clip it in place, and have this nice kind of triple-barreled gun going. And it does look rather nice. This is actually where the mech tech thing works. Every other figure that I've seen, it doesn't really work that well. It just, like I said, looks dumb. But there is that. He does have a little mech tech port on the tip, so you can take, and I guess it's meant to be a rifle of some kind, maybe a blade. But you can take it, mount it to the front, and then give him a giant gunno death if you so desire. Don't know why you would. It looks kind of goofy to me. But you can take this off. I guess I'll leave the hose attached. Duke, you can take that off. And one thing I really like is the hose is very G1 kind of thing. If you're a G1er, you can be like, hey, he has a hose! But it is on this kind of a little, I don't know what you call it, a turbine kind of deal. Ammo storage, maybe, whatever. I like it. It works nicely. But you can take his gun. If you leave it off for a second, you can take his arm out. And you can give Shockwave two arms. If you don't want the whole gun arm thing. This does unpeg, but it's kind of tricky to get it back in. So I'm going to leave it out right where it is. And you can kind of take the gun arm and somewhat mount it to this arm, or the gun and mount it to this arm. But the way it's made, the hole's a lot higher up than it was here. It doesn't clip in place as well as it should. If you kind of balance it, you can somewhat, maybe, do it. Maybe not. Here, I'll just prop it right up here and... Yay! I don't know. Be cool if you could really do that, but, you know, I'm not really that annoyed with it. And you can also take his little rifle and mount it from this arm, or you can even have him holding it in his hand if you want to give him that kind of look. But again, since his elbow bends all weird, you're kind of stuck doing, you know, that kind of stuff. Eh. But to transform him, and I really like his transformation, I go ahead and leave the hose attached. You can go ahead and take it off this part if you want. It's easier to leave the hose on in my experience with this wonderful little toy here. First, take his hands, fold them away, get them all lined up, get his arms up so I can do a little happy dance. Go around to his legs, take the knee pads, fold them in first, take his toesies and unclip them. And they're going to fold up and then push all the way until you hear the click. Doop, 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 boop. Heels, fold away, like goop. No problem there. And then take his legs, and you're going to rotate them so the gaps face outwards. And kind of leave them like that for now. Go around to his back, undo these little pieces all through here. Undo the head from the chest, and then unfold these little parts in the back to get that. Take his head, rotate it around, and this whole thing's going to swing up and form around the head to hide his little face, which is pretty clever, I think. It kind of gives him a little battle mask. Which, that's kind of cute. I don't know. Leave those out, and then rotate this around. And there's that. Now go into the front here. You're going to unpeg the rib cage, slide that down, and then take his little side treads here, and then swing those around. It does feel like you're going to break it at first, but you got to kind of force it. And then get it where those are extended like that. So again, rotate it so it's like that. And then that's all there. It's just a big glob of mess. This is where things start coming together. Take the legs, rotate them inwards, and kind of leave the arms out of the way for now. And get them all tucked away like that. You see there's a front of the tank forming. Take this whole little section here, it's going to slide upwards. And if you look, there's a little tab on each side of the legs there and there. There's little slots on each side of this. So swing this up and then tab the legs into this little middle, I guess I could call it a turbine. But and so that is all in there. And the hose will stick out to the front, just kind of wave about. When that's done, you can fold the head up, and again, two little tabs on the front of here, two little slots underneath there. Swing it up, that's going to tab in, and that's going to tab in. And it's very, very solid. It is amazing how well this thing holds together. It's shocking, it's awe-inspiring. I want to grow up and be just like it someday. Now, when that's done, again, tab here, and then a tab here. Little slots on each sides of what was his chest, and they're going to fit until they clip into place. And with those in, the rib cage will peg into little holes. If you can see my hand through there, maybe, I don't know. But two little holes along here to secure all of that together. Now, you're basically done. All that's left is take the arms, flip them around, and I think I have the little part backwards. But anyway, you're going to have the arms flipped around. So first, this little, what I call a roller bit. Excuse me. Whew. Little roller bit will fit into this little groove along here. You do that first, and you notice it doesn't really lock in place. If you push the back part of the arm here, it actually fits into a small little clip and secures it, which is great. The first time I had this toy transformed, I was really kind of getting frustrated because you would have this happen. It's like, lock in place. But if you push right back here, dook, locks everything in. Fantastic. Now you can leave it like this, and of course you can pull the hose, that makes some kind of Cybertronian car, but that's not what Shockwave is. Take his gun arm, put it back on his arm there. This little pit, this little bit will fit right back in there, and it likes to roll around on you. Doop doop doop. There's that. And I take this, and you can mount it back there if you so desire. Or you can have it going, you know, on the side. There's a lot of mech tech ports on him there. And it looks like you maybe even got one, what, here? Nah, you don't. But lots of little parts you can put it on there, do whatever you want. But that is Shockwave in his tank mode. As I'm calling it a tank mode. Don't know the official name, don't really care. It's a tank as far as I'm concerned. And I'll just doop. And then I'll just doop. There you go. There is Shockwave. I really like this overall toy. Everything is so compact and it fits in there perfectly. You can't really make out what piece is what in this mode unless you actually know how it transforms. Of course, yeah, you can say, oh, well, there's his toes and yeah, there's his hand and oh, there's his head. But like I said, it's like his head's watching. It's like it's watching you. Ooh, hang on, wait. Ooh, what if, can you get his head in there? No, he's watching you. Anyway. I'm rambling now. Really like this mode. He does have wheels there. And these little front little turbine bits are also wheels. So he rolls surprisingly nicely for this whole little tank mode kind of thing. The mech tech does still work. You have to make sure that the hose, and it may actually be better to kind of work it around in different angles and different ways. But as long as the hose is straight up the middle like this, the mech tech weapon mechanism thing should work no problem. And give him just a super cannon. I mean, that's awesome. I really like this toy, and it stands out. It's probably one of the better figures of the Dark of the Moon line, and I'm certainly glad I got it. If you've had any kind of desire to get this toy in the past, any pictures, I would say pick it up. The only major downside is, of course, its size. Leader class treatment would be fantastic, but I know it's not going to happen. But I can always dream. I like this toy quite a bit, though. And just so you can get an idea of how it looks without it, I'll go ahead and take the hose out since I'm done anyway. And there you go. If you don't want the hose in place, that's how he looks. Still looks pretty awesome. I would say pick it up. It's a fantastic little figure, and it just looks great for the collection. And my phone's going off now. So, hope you guys have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.